Hello dear children of class 3 and welcome to yet another online class for general knowledge. Dear children, today we are going to do a new lesson, food for brain. Now you see dear children, in our human body we have many organs doing different functions. But the brain is the master of them all. You see, the brain controls each and every function of our body. Every function, whether it's voluntary or involuntary. Okay, now our body, like I told you, our body mostly has two kind of functions, voluntary and involuntary. Voluntary functions are the functions which are under our control. And involuntary, not under our control. Okay, voluntary functions are the functions which are under our control, and involuntary functions are the functions which are not under our control. So you see dear children, like suppose there are some functions like closing of your fist. This you can think and do, right? This you can think and do. This is under your control. But there are some functions like your heartbeat, not under your control. So all these functions are controlled and regulated by the brain. Brain not only controls the functions of our body, but brain also helps us to think, decide, make decisions, distinguish between right and wrong. Even when we are morally confused whether what we are going to do is correct or not, it's the brain that helps us to decide what to do. Now, you know that phrase is there, always think from your heart. Actually, heart has no thinking function at all. Bear that in your mind. It's just a phrase, okay? Heart has no thinking function at all. Every thinking and controlling work of our body is carried out by our brain. So you can understand that brain is the most important organ of our body. In case the connection of the brain severs from the body, somehow the brain is disconnected from the rest of the body, the body will stop getting messages and command. The body will stop processing things. Then what will happen? Our body will go into paralysis. It will not be able to move at all. Okay. Now let me explain to you in general. Okay. Though it's above your class level, but you will need to learn how your brain works. You see, dear children, first thing first. Suppose I am pinching myself here. Then what happens? Through the nerves, the message that I am being pinched, okay, will go from my hand to my brain. The brain will process the pinch and then brain will send the command to the hand muscles to pull back. That's why when someone pinches us, we pull our hand back. So you see, every function in our body, voluntary, involuntary, thinking, looking, processing, everything is controlled by our brain. So if there is one organ in our body that needs a very special care, if there is one organ in our body that requires constant attention and it needs to be kept in proper health, then that is the brain. That is the brain. You see, dear children, without the brain working, without the brain functioning properly, it will be impossible for people to judge, think and decide. And not only that, even their body will fail to function, like I told you earlier. So today we are going to learn about some of the food items which are required to keep this important organ of our body healthy. You see, our brain already has its own protection system. It sits within the skull, the cranium, okay? Within the skull, the bony skeletal structure. It protects it from external injuries up to a certain extent. But in order for the brain to function properly, it requires very healthy nutrients which come from a very specific diet. These food items that we are going to talk about today are often given by parents to children because it's believed that they help in increasing the memory capacity of The children, as I told you earlier, it's brain's job to think. So you can understand that healthy brains can retain much more information than unhealthy ones. Healthy brain can make better decisions than the unhealthy ones. So let's see. How it goes, okay? So first item here, number one, peanuts and peanut butter, okay? Peanuts are one of the common source of good nutrient that can make the brain sharp, that can make the, that can keep the brain healthy. And nowadays, even in market, you have peanut butter, right? Most of your houses, you like to eat peanut butter sandwich. You like to, you put peanut butter in the bread and eat it. A very wholesome diet. You, if you don't, you must include it in your diet. It will help improve your brain capacity. Then comes second one. Vegetables. Vegetables, especially the green leafy vegetables, are a very good source of vitamins. Vitamins, or vitamins as you call them, are very important for, to keep the brain healthy, are very important to ensure that the brain functions properly. So you must eat lot of green vegetable, if possible green leafy vegetables like spinach and all. It will help keep your brain healthy. Then comes third one, milk and yogurt. Milk and yogurt. Milk and yogurt. Now you see, milk is known as the complete food. Milk is known as the wholesome nourishment. Taking milk means you are putting almost all the nutrients in your body at once. It helps you to keep not only your body but also your brain healthy. And it will be much more better if you can take yogurt. You know what yogurt is, right? You often eat it. It comes in packs. You can buy it from out, right? A yogurt also a milk product. Remember, yogurt is a milk product, and it also helps to keep the brain healthy. Then comes fourth one, oats. Oats are rich in fiber as well as certain vitamins, okay? Fiber keep our stomach clear, okay? But the vitamins present in it keep our brain sharp. Now, dear children, oats are a very popular diet among the fitness enthusiast, okay? Those who are into bodybuilding or any kind of fitness stuff or athletism, that athletes, sportsmen, they take oats. Now, you can take oats in many ways, okay? You can have them cooked like porridge, means khichdi or dalia. Or what you can do, you can simply grind them up in the mixture. Put a little bit of water, boil it up, put a bit of salt in it, okay? And have it directly. Of course, it's going to be tasteless, but trust me, it is very good for your brain. Then you have kidney beans. Kidney beans, also known to most of you as rajma, right? Most of you like to take it with rice, good vegetable. Now, kidney beans also contain specific vitamins which help to sharpen your brain and keep it healthy. But there is a catch with using kidney beans. Remember, some people often complain that when they eat kidney beans or rajma, they get gas, constipation. So you need to be careful. If the kidney bean doesn't suit you, if the kidney bean doesn't suit you, then you must avoid taking it. Same thing goes, dear children, with peanut and peanut butter also. People, some people, okay, it's a rare case, but some people have mild peanut or peanut butter allergy. If you are allergic to peanut or peanut butter, you must avoid taking it. And also, milk. I'll provide you with the clip of the book, photo clip of the book. You will draw these food items in your GK copy and you will name them. Okay. Thank you very much. Stay safe.